Hi everyone, this is Caesar with Jet Mac Designs. On this week's video, I'm going to show you how I take a basic piece of wood like looks like this and turn it into an awesome looking rustic wood sign like that. Alright, it's an easy project, anyone can do it. You're just going to need a piece of wood, any size really. You're going to need some text cut in vinyl and then any color spray paint you want. Alright, and some sandpaper. And that's it. So let's head on over to the shop and let's get this project started.
Alright, so here we have our vinyl decal that we're going to use to make our sign with. I like to make my decals to the exact dimensions of my wood board. It makes it really easy for aligning the sign. So I like cutting the corners there and leaving those triangles in place so that I can align the sign on the wood. On the next step, it makes it really easy to align the decal onto the wood. Okay, so now I'm removing all the extra material around the letters, and the letters is what's going to block the paint, so this is an important step. So I love those corners there because it makes it really easy to align the sign. So now I'm going to cut some transfer tape here. I'm going to stick it onto the decal and then squeegee it on there. Apply enough pressure so that you're able to get the vinyl to transfer from the paper backing to the transfer tape. All right, so we're gonna remove the paper backing. We're gonna use those triangles to align the decal. Okay, so now the vinyl is onto the wood and this sign is now ready for painting. Alright, so we're going to use a colonial red on this sign. I like to use a contrasting color because our pine wood is light and that's going to be the color of our letters. So you want to have a background that's dark enough that you'll be able to see the letters when it's hung on your wall. So we're going to use a colonial red, and on the first coat that you paint the sign with, you want to go pretty light. Okay, try not to puddle the paint in between the letters, especially in between the letters, because it's going to cause the paint to bleed through and you're going to have these ugly streaks inside of the letters. So try to keep it as light as possible on your first coat, and then let it dry for a couple of minutes, and then go ahead and do the second coat a little thicker. All right, so this is what our sign looks like now that it's been painted. We are going to remove the vinyl now from the sign. Your letter should look nice and clean, sharp edges, and perfect. Alright, so this is what our sign looks like now. Nice, nice job. Alright, so this is the last step of the making of our sign. We're going to take 100 grit sandpaper and we are going to begin sanding. And the amount of the stress you give your sign, that's really up to you how much distress you want to give the sign. I personally like to start off by sanding it evenly all the way across, and then I go in a little deeper in random areas throughout the sign, and I like to round off the corners a little bit also. And the 100 grit sandpaper makes it really easy to do this because it's a little bit more rougher than the 150 or 180. So I like to, for this step, I like to use 100, 120 even. It's good for this, but I think the 100 is the best one. And then what I like to do afterwards is take a 220 grit sandpaper and lightly sand the surface to even it out. Sometimes you get these like minor scratches as you're sanding the edges, with the 100 especially. I try to be careful not to give scratches, but you know, the 220, if you did by chance have some minor scratches, then the 220 will buff those out nicely. And you're gonna see that in just a few seconds here. Here it is. So that's a 220 sandpaper there. So I'm gonna put it on, and then I'm gonna just slightly sand the surface to remove any scuffs on the sign. And the sign is done. It's got the distress. It's ready to be shipped out to the customer. And that's it. That's how we make our custom spray painted wood signs at Jet Mac Designs.